Few love the limelight like former Italian Prime Minister Silvio Berlusconi, here about to participate in a live interview with some of his most vociferous critics. Elections are a month and a half away, and Berlusconi is hoping to get his old job back. Journalist Marco Travaglio has chronicled Berlusconi's checkered political and personal past. He cares about communications because he's only communications, only publicity, Travaglio tells me before the show. The fact that he's still in the news after 20 years excites him. Berlusconi's alter ego and another contender for the leadership of Italy is current caretaker Prime Minister Mario Monti, soft-spoken, serious, and sober.
Il presidente del consiglio, il senatore Mario Monti.
In a live radio interview, he talked policy and economics, but had to be coaxed to reveal that, unlike Berlusconi, he can't sing and isn't very good at telling jokes. Monti was appointed in late 2011 to prevent a Greek-style meltdown of the Italian economy. His combination of spending cuts and tax hikes has been painful, but he has received high marks for his management of the economy. Polls show that Pier Luigi Bersani of the left-leaning Democratic Party has the best chance of winning the most votes. But there are many slips twixt the start of a campaign and the formation of a new government. Edda, a pensioner, has kind words for Monti.
Monti ha fatto agito molto bene.
He's done well, she says. He's responsible and has brought this country a better, more decent vision than before was lacking. Anna, a store clerk, prefers Berlusconi, who, she feels, will get the economy moving again, create jobs for young people and cut taxes, because for young Italians, she says, there's no hope, there's no future.
Non c'è speranza e non c'è futuro.
But in a country where politics often amount to a lot of sound and fury, but yield nothing, cynicism is rife. They're all disgusting, says Augusto, a pensioner of the politicians. We should get rid of them and replace them with more serious people. But since there aren't any such people, it's better just not to vote.
This is a minor...
And for that, says Professor Leonardo Morlino, the politicians only have themselves to blame.
It's a strong competition between parties, among different parties, between the two sides, that in a sense delegitimate one another. And that, of course, is also reflected in what the citizens think.
So many expect lots of smoke, but not much fire in these elections.
There's a joke making the rounds these days, and it goes something like this. The three main contenders for the premiership are in a raft in the rapids that hits a rock and starts to sink. So, who's saved? Monti? No. Bersani? No. Berlusconi? No. So who is saved? The Italian people. Ben Wiedemann, CNN, Rome.